Shalom. I want to start off by saying, giving all praise, honor, and glory to the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakaha, Kwadash. Salaki, I'm, a little low voice right now. It's real early in the morning, about 4:30 or so, whatever. All right. Double honors to the apostles and elders, a great millstone of whom I learn from daily. Healthy shalom to you, brothers, that are out there doing the work in truth and sincerity. You know, what is more of a reasonable sacrifice to the Heavenly Father? Huh? What's more of a reasonable sacrifice to the Heavenly Father? Making your body a living sacrifice. What's why would you not want to do that? Why would you want to go anything in the cares of this world or whatever, blah, blah, blah? That's not what this lesson's about, but I'm watching GMS Vegas sit downs, and he just posed the question, are you wasting your time? I mean, what the hell are you doing? Why are you worried about this world? Why are you worried about the cares of this world and the things that are temporal? You jakes are full of shit, man. You know, a lot of you, and to the ones that understand and have the eye salve and do the things that they're supposed to be doing. Shalom to you, you brothers and sisters. Of course, here's another lesson going into Eve. Something popped up on my, on my feed there, and it just reminded me of something. The so-called N-dub, so-called black woman, and Northern Kingdom too. Because I'm married to a Gadite, right? Y'all haven't been tender and delicate to your men. Right. That's right. Absolutely. But you haven't done your due diligence or due benevolence to your men. Okay. Now, we do realize and understand there's a whole lot of Pookies and Ray Rays and Ramondos out there. We understand, dead beats, if you will. Deuteronomy 28th chapter goes into that too. We understand that. Okay. But there's a match made in hell, if you will. I just use that word, just for lack of better words. All right. Which is, damn, Eve in the garden. You can read it in Genesis 3. I got it pulled up, that made a covenant with this damn devil. And why not just go into the men also? Because a lot of these camps, not Great Millstone. Also, they've also made a covenant with the devil. See? He's a great deceiver. But the scripture said the deceived and the deceiver are his. You understand? He's a great deceiver. Here it is. You know the truth. Yeah, I'm talking about, Akiam and Akwath, right? Here it is. You know the truth. But you laid down and made a covenant with this goddamn devil. What in the world is wrong with you? And then through subtlety, you accusing the brotherhood. You got Deacon Destruction mode and all that. And the reason why you cats get rebuked is because you're going the hell off, man. You doing wrong, right? You doing wrong, man. Okay, whatever, man. You know better. Than just regular Christians, that like to try, because you can't give us a hard time. It's not possible, They like to try to give us a hard time because of their doctrine and the things that they think they've understood for so long. And we coming along, we're telling you, your ass is dead flat wrong, man. You dead flat wrong. And you know what? If you're not careful, You're gonna be a part of the two-thirds club. You missile food. This is Matthew 13 verse 22. He also that receiveth seed, and it's I black culture. I can't it's Black History Month. It's a damn joke. They're making fun of you right in front of your face, and then you got these people, that proud black. I can't stand black people. Matthew 13 verse 22. He also that receiveth seed among the thorns is he that heareth the word. and that care and the care of this world and the deceitfulness of riches choke the word, and he becometh unfruitful. Did you hear what the scripture said? The deceivableness of riches and the cares of this world and the things of this world, what are they? It chokes the word and becometh what? Unfruitful. Okay, now look, it's 444. See, we got to know what these things represent and mean. Now, I want to show you this since this popped up in my feed here. Let's go here. I want you to watch this because she damn sure ain't tender and delicate towards us. 46 years. Cares. Anyway, so lock you for the, you know, gay ass music or whatever. But yeah, you know, that popped up in my feed. Now this, this has to be said because this is the truth. I don't know that man, you know, from Adam, if you will. He could very well be an Israelite. And as a matter of fact, she could very well be a Edomite or any kind of different nation. We don't know. Okay. But the point of this video, you already understand what the point of this video. The point of this video is this. Eve is not tender and delicate like that towards us. You see the smile on her face? She's comfortable dealing with the devil. Okay. And again, I'm not calling that man a devil. You know, because I really don't know him. I haven't searched his spirit or nothing like that. So I don't know, but off face value, the damn it, just listen and pay attention. Off face value, he's probably a freaking Edomite, okay? Because you saw the smile on her face, how happy she is and all that. Eve just ain't like that towards her men. As a matter of fact, there's a video I did, I don't know, sometime back. I guess it was months ago, all right? Because, you know, we do so many videos, sometimes it's a blur, all right? Okay, it's not about the, you know, how many videos you make or nothing like that. It's about edifying the body, you know, staying on fire. But the video that I did showed you and told you these women out of the horse's mouth, if you will. What were they saying? Well, you know how we treat y'all. They were saying this. We know how we treat you, and we do it on purpose, and we don't treat other men like that. Just you. Why? It's written in the Bible. Let's go here. See, it's prophetic. Okay? Now, in the end, you're going to see. You're going to see and you're going to understand. Let's get to the point. You know, I'm talking about you Eves and you men that have been effeminized, man. You already through, man. Damn transformers, transmissions, you know, calling other camps gay. Calling a great millstone gay because they get on people, and we get on every damn body. It don't matter who it is, man. And there ain't no radar neither. It's just it is what it is. If you going off, you're gonna get rebuked. Open rebuke is better than secret love. So screw all that. You sound gay, nigga. Verse 23. But he that receiveth seed into the good ground, what? Receiveth seed into the good ground is he that heareth the word and understand it. Okay. And you know, I'm not going back and forth with some dumb niggas that can't even understand that the letter J wasn't even created until the 1600. After that, you stupid, man. All right. Which also beareth fruit and bringeth forth some hundredfold, some 60 and some 30. Okay. Verse 24, another parable put he forth unto them, saying, the kingdom of heaven is likened unto a man which soweth good seed in his field. See, it's what? Soweth good seed in his field. What's that good seed? Any seed that's an Israelite. That's good seed right there. You understand? All right. Oh boy. Verse 25. But while men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat and went his way. What did that say? An enemy came and he sowed tares. What does that mean? That means that the damn Edomites came and sowed, put their seed, you know, up in the womb. And you could, there's plenty of examples of this. You Eves forget so quickly that they were graping you and taking you from your husbands. They were buck breaking. This lesson's not going to go into that, but it's so much. There's been movies made about it. You can see it and understand it, but you covet and take hold to your enemy. Why? Because you're hypergamous. All you're looking for is comfort and all that blah, blah, blah. And the so-called black man, Latino man, Native American man can't give you that. And even if he can give you that, you shun him away like he ain't shit. There is a recompense for that. Answer that question. I'm just saying. But the enemy came and he sowed tares. Let's read it again, verse 25. But while men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares amongst the wheat and went his way. But when the blade was sprung up and brought forth fruit, then appeared the tares also. What did the scripture say? What did Yahushua say he told the angels to do with the tares and the wheat? He said, gather them both together and let them grow together. Until what? To the harvest. All right. That's right before them ICBMs come down and start burning every damn thing. Right here in Babylon, baby. And, you know, maybe other places. You know, we already know and understand that land, the so-called state of Israel, that's going to get destroyed by them ICBMs, too. Surely the least of the flock shall draw them out. Okay. See, but this place is through. And when the reapers, which it's in fact our brothers, the angels, when the reapers come, and they thrust that sickle. What's it going to do? What did he say? What did Yahweh say? You know, in the scriptures, what did it say? He said, let them both grow together. And you take the wheat and you take the wheat to my barn, which in fact is the chariots. Edahawad just showed a chariot, a beautiful chariot spinning around, looking all kinds of beautiful up in the sky. Look up for your redemption. Draw nigh. You saw it. Mm-hmm. You know, matter of fact. Look, there she is. That's the lady that wrote a book called A White Man's Whore. Can't make this up. You can't make this up, man. All right. Here it go. Check it out.
Kal halayim la yahawa bahashim yahawashai bahashim rakakwa dash brakatha. A chariot right over the crib. You see the crib right there.
I see the crib, though. I see the crib. And I also see what? That's his barn. It's gonna be big. Every eye shall see him. Revelation 1 of verse 7. See, but it's not gonna go into that. See, I'm going off the lesson. Okay, all right. So let's go ahead. Let's keep reading. Nope. Let's not. Let's go here first. All right, because I got a couple other clips. I'm gonna go ahead and show you that. I'll show you a couple other clips here. Check this out. This is she like a deer in headlights.
That issue with Caucasian men, I never, sex was never brought up. They just wanted to just love on me. And I mean, to the point where like, I dated this one guy and he would pick my food up from the table and carry it to my car. He would hold the door for me. When I got in the car, he would close the door. He would get on
Here it is. You don't, these women, you don't want a man. You want a fucking chauffeur. Huh? You want, what's his name? What was that show? Was it Bentley? I forget, you know, Salakia. You want a damn, you don't want a husband. You don't want a hedge of protection. You want a fucking chauffeur, man. What in the world is, see, this is, I had never had a problem with the white man because he would even pick my food up and carry me to the door, open the door for me, open and then take the food inside and make sure I was warm. So, and hurry me up inside so I wouldn't have to get cold. And then he drew me a bath. All that shit's getting ready to be over. It's all getting ready to be over.
Topic that I want to talk about is interracial dating. And not just any interracial dating, specific interracial dating between white men and black women. Some of you guys know I wrote a book about it.
Huh?
It's called A White Man's Whore. It's on Amazon. You heard that?
You can go to Amazon and grab that one.
Is interracial dating. And not just any interracial dating, specific interracial dating between white men and black women. Some of you guys know I wrote a book about it. It's called A White Man's Whore. It's on Amazon.
You can't make that up. Verse 27. So the servants of the house, oh boy. So the servants of the householder came and said unto him, Sir, thou didst not thou sow good seed in thy field? From whence then have the tares? And where the hell where these tares come from? See? Verse 28, he said unto them, an enemy, a what? Have you Israelites lost track of your mind? Did you forget that we have enemies, or did you ever know in the first place? You know, Salakia. Let me get that back right. Or did you ever know in the first place that you have enemies? What in the world are you thinking? You don't know what you're worshiping. You have no idea what's going on. That's why you can't let go of that name, Jebus. That's why you can't let go of the things of this world. You think everything's going to be okay. You are proud to be an American. I'm an African American. Black History Month is the highlight of your freaking year. You niggas are crazy, man. Yeah, how about Shimmy Al-Shot getting ready to come and smooth dissolve all this? Okay, you heard what the scripture said. Where these tares come from? Verse 28, and he said unto them, an enemy have done this. The servant said unto him, wilt thou then that we go and gather them up? He said, can we go gather them up, please, and get rid of these damn enemies? You saw that, didn't you? Oh, I want to dance with somebody who loves me. Well, you know what? We showed you, we have been showing you plenty of love, man. Now you got, it's a whole damn thing going on. That's a movement called MGTOW. It's called Men Going Their Own Way. You see, how about Shem Yahshua is opening everybody's eyes up? And we see the nonsense and the bullcrap that you put us through and continue to do yet to this day. Okay? You know, but hey, all these benefits and all that shit is going away. The vintage shall fail, as the scripture said. Let's keep going. Mm-mm-mm. Let's keep going. But in the meantime, we staying occupied in prophecies. Did you see that beautiful chariot? Man, they're all over the place. Call halal yahab ba shimmy abashai. They're all over the place. The eyes of the Lord are 10,000 times brighter than the sun. They watching us. They can see what's going on. All right. No, I'm not watching no Yahweh. I don't know. And I don't think so. And they got them looking like some white Vikings, which in fact, the Vikings were so-called black people in anyway, man. See, it's all kinds of damn nonsense going on out here. But the truth that should be that it's been so long without fruit shall be declared. Verse 30, let them both grow together until the harvest. And in the time of the harvest, I will say to the reapers, who are the reapers? The reapers are the angels, man. You just saw it in the elder video right there. Them angels that's operating these beautiful celestial vehicles, these chariots. Okay? Gather ye together first the tares and bind them in bundles to burn them. But gather the wheat into my barn. Oh, where's this barn at? There's this barn right there. See?
Yeah. Scripture say, look up for thy redemption, draweth nigh. Look at Israel, it's high time to awake out of sleep, because salvation is nearer than when we believe. Salvation is nearer than when we believe. And another chariot just flew over my head, you know what I'm saying, probably about 10 minutes ago. You got the chariots right above the crib, man. You see it, man, twisting. This camera right here don't even do it no justice, but you see it back there twerking, man. And a chariot, you know what I'm saying, just flew over my head probably about
right.
10
That's his barn, man. That's, you know, I mean, we don't know exactly what, you know, his big, huge chariot is going to look like. And that's because it's going to be ceremonies going on. It's beautiful. you know. But they gather them all together and burn them damn tears, man. Screw them tears, you know, because they're nothing but the enemies. It don't matter how you look. Was that sister, you know what I'm talking about? Was it Tia or Tamara or whatever the hell their name? Them, they damn tears. Mm-hmm. Genesis 3, verse 1. Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field. What does this say? Why is it saying it? Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field. Let's go here, Salakia. Let me get me another video put up, because I watched all that. Okay. There we go. Just something in the background. I like to keep brothers' videos up just all the damn time. All right. Now the serpent, even when even working and all that, just it's something in it, you know, because always meditating on the scriptures. All right. And I know that's the last thing I wanted to hear, though, was damn gorilla Hebrew. Reprobates. Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field, which the Lord Yahweh, our power, had made. See, he had made all this. And he said unto the woman, yea, have the Most High said, ye shall not eat of every tree of the garden? What did he say? He told us not to do that. And the woman said unto the serpent, see that? What she say? And if you can receive this, that serpent was a man. He was given and feeding Eve philosophies. You see, he was giving Eve and feeding her what? Philosophies. He was telling her a damn lie, like he does yet to this day. And now he just uses you up for whatever the hell he wants to use you for. And you take it hook, line, and sinker. Why? Because you have Pergamus and you think you got something good going on, but you've been tricked. What Dave Chappelle? He said, gotcha, bitch. Okay. He did it. Dave Chappelle said, gotcha, bitch. Okay. Because that's he basically got you. He has taken you, man. He's subtile, man. Let's look the word up. Subtle. All right. I said subtile, but you know, that's my countryside. All right. Let's look up. Oh, I don't know what happened. Oh, well, it just automatically went there. Call halal Yahabashim, Yahushua. All right. Especially, let's see, subtle, especially of charge or distinction. So delicate or precise as the difficult to analyze or describe. Right. Sneaky, right? Subtle, hard to pinpoint, right? A mixture of or effect, delicately complex and understated. See that? Complex and understated. See, there's more here. See, making use of clever or indirect methods to achieve something. Do you see that? Do you see that? Look up definitions. It really helps you gain more understanding of the scriptures, man. And, you know, and we've been taught that by the apostles and the elders and the bishops all the way on down. Man, use these tools, man. Okay? It helps you understand what's going on. All right? Capable of making fine distinctions. That's awesome. I like this one right here, though. Let's read it again. Making use of clever or indirect methods to achieve something, right? And what he want to achieve? Trick your ass. And you got tricked, and yet to this day you still tricked. That's why they're writing books like a white man's whore. That's why they you know, look, you see smile on her face, she's so happy. I want to dance with somebody who loves me. You know, basically Benton. That's that show. I think it was Benton. Or screw it. You want a Jeffrey from oh shit! You want Jeffrey, man, from Fresh Prince? You want somebody just yes, my lord? Crazy as hell, man. You see, and as soon as a man, you know, real man, speaks up and says something, you call it toxic masculinity. It's just stupid, man. It's nonsense. And when the woman said unto the serpent, "All right, we may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, Salakia, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst thereof of the garden, the Most High power have said, ye shall not eat of it." He said don't do that. All right. "Neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die." But the serpent, he was subtle, you know. He was a trickster, right? All right. Verse 4. And the serpent said unto the woman, ye shall not surely die. For the Most High doth know that in the day ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be open, and ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil. And really, that's what the woman wanted. She wants to be over you. It's that easy. She wants to be a god. She wants to be over you. She wants more than what she was created for in the first place. You remember, you came out of man. And the scripture goes into it. It tells you, you are of the man, and the man is not of the woman. It's an order going on here. See, he's subtle. He's subtle. All right. Subtile. And whatever, however you say it. No, there's more down. There was more down here. Okay. All right. In an elaborate way. Ooh, arranged in an ingenious and elaborate way. Okay. Crafty, cunning, crafty. Their scripture is Psalms 83. That reminds me of Psalms 83. How Esau, Edom, they have taken crafty counsel, and they said, come, let us cut them off from being a nation. And, you know, and one of them ways of doing that and destroying kings and destroying nations, the household. All right. You know, it's everybody should know by now. It's been a hell of a campaign to destroy the so-called Black, Latino, and a Native American household, man, which in fact are the Israelites. It's that simple. Goodness gracious. Okay, microphone's on. I may want to stop this and see if it's still recording. All right, stay tuned. Verse 21, though hand join in hand, the wicked shall not be unpunished. But the seed, we were reading about seed earlier, where I mean not, but the seed, an enemy had came in, and when he sowed tares, right? He put his seed, you know, up in the mix. All right. But the seed of the righteous shall be delivered. The what? The seed of the righteous. But the what? Though hand join in hand, the wicked shall not be unpunished. So you're not going to be able to save these damn devils, even if you land down with them. And that's that. Okay. I'm not going to make this too much longer anyway, because I only had like three scriptures left. I just wanted to make sure it was still recording. And lo and behold, it was. For everything, man. Micah 7, verse 10. Then she that is my enemy shall see it, and shame shall cover her, which say unto me, where is the Lord Yahweh thy power? My eyes shall behold her, and now she shall be trotted down as a mire in the street. Pig style, man. We've looked it up before. The lessons have been done. You got to, look back, man. This is just, we've done so many lessons. But then again, they take, you can go back and look at your lessons. And, they destroy your lessons and take them off. And they do all kinds of different things. Why? Because we're telling the truth. We're telling the truth right here, man. And you got these dudes, the whole armor, and it's spelled D-A, whole armor, wearing these damn flat bill hats, looking like a bunch of assholes, man. Paul going off, IUIC teaching a book of Hebrews is going off, a plate of fish, and Deuteronomy 28, verse 56, the tender and delicate woman among you, which would not adventure to set the sole of her foot upon the ground for delicateness. Not for you. But a white man's whore, that's a deal. In tenderness, her eyes shall be evil towards the husband of her bosom, and towards her son, and towards her daughter. Prophecies. See, we read prophecies. We read prophecies. See, that's the problem with a lot of you people. You're not going in. You're not staying occupied in prophecy. You full of debate. Great millstone. That's why they don't debate. We don't debate because there's nothing to debate. The scriptures are written. If you don't get it, you don't get it. The scripture tells us what how to interact and be with people. If they can't hear the word, then damn it, screw them. Shake off the dust of your feet. You got the blood off your hands. That's that. You don't need. I ain't going back and forth with you. I ain't debating you. Why would I want to debate you? The word's written. It's already right here. We're reading it right now. And towards her young one that cometh out from between her feet, and towards her children, which she shall bear. For she shall eat them for the want of all things. It's going to the siege, right? 70, 80, all right, things. Salakia. But these are the curses, too. You know, maybe this is coming back. Oh, boy. Things secretly in the siege and straightness. Salakia. Read it right. All right. Wherewith thine enemy shall distress thee in thy gates. Did that say enemy? Did that say enemy again? But though hand joining hand, the wicked shall not be unpunished. The scripture just said that, man. Right here. It just said that in Proverbs 11, verse 21. That the enemy, what? They sow seed, and you still loving it. You know, what was that McDonald's commercial? I'm loving it. You still loving it. You Burger King, have it your way. You can have it your way, but Micah 7 and verse 10 getting ready to pop off. Okay? Hopefully this lesson was edifying. This is crazy nonsense, man. I mean, that's... You getting ready to feel the wrath of Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, and there ain't no stopping it, man. All that comfortableness is going away. Hopefully this lesson was edifying. Salakia. Giving all praise, honor, and glory to the Heavenly Father, His only begotten Son, Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai Bahashem, Rekaha Kodash. Double honors to the apostles and the elders, a great millstone of whom I learn from daily. Healthy shalom to the brothers that are out there doing the work in truth and sincerity. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Every chance you get, chant this place down. Kwam Yasharala and Wa Abai Baba. Boom. Shalom. Unbelievable.